you for your patience over these past 5 days. I think it really was a wonderful display of democracy at its finest. As all of us know who work at the legislature, to have the public become involved in an issue is something that is that belongs to all of you. I know that over the past 5 days, several people have lost their jobs because being here was more important to testify. And so I am so proud of the people of the state of Hawaii who came out to be a part of this process with us to have your voices heard before your government. That being said, Mr. Chairman and Madam Co-Chair, I want to thank you for the amendments that you folks have put into this bill. I think that the public was heard in some certain instances, but I do continue to submit that this bill continues to have flaws. For example, Mr. Chairman, you just stated that this bill is based on the Connecticut exemption. However, if you read the actual language in the Connecticut law, it clearly states, notwithstanding any other provision of law, a religious organization, association, or society, or any nonprofit institution or organization operated, supervised, or controlled by, or in conjunction with a religious organization, association, or society shall not be required to provide services, accommodations, advantages, facilities, goods, or privileges to an individual if the request for such services, accommodations, advantages, facilities, goods, or privileges is related to the solemnization of a marriage or celebration of a marriage, and such solemnization or celebration is in violation of their religious beliefs and faith. Mr. Chairman, I would submit that the exemption in our current bill, our House Draft 1, is not the same. In addition, Mr. Chairman, we've talked a lot about public accommodations. The state of Washington, which is considered the third most atheist state and considered one of the most liberal states, they recently had, in fact, legalized marijuana. They, too, in their same-sex marriage law, they have an express carve-out, and it states, a religious organization shall be immune from any claim or cause of action, including a claim pursuant to Chapter 49.60, which is the equivalent of 489 for us, HRS 49, based on its refusal to provide accommodations, facilities, advantages, privileges, services, or goods related to the solemnization or celebration of a marriage. My second point in this, Mr. Chairman, is this. You know, we've had thousands of people come and testify, and they talked about the process. And while you did take some exception to that, I must respectfully disagree, Mr. Chairman. The fact of the matter is this. With this particular measure right now, had we gone through a regular session, an HD1, a House Draft 1, would have come out of the Judiciary Committee. It subsequently, that HT1 would have then gone to the Finance Committee, where the public would have had a second opportunity to comment on these particular amendments. At this point in a special session, there is no more opportunity for the public to be involved, and that's where the process is flawed, Mr. Chairman. You know, we've had 57 hours of testimony, but again, this was done in an expedited short period of time. The process has been flawed, and the fact is there would have been additional hearings for the public to now comment on these amendments that are being made, and that opportunity has been taken away from the public. My third point, Mr. Chairman, is this. You know, this bill, ironically, is entitled Relating to Equal Rights. And yet, Senate Bill 1, House Draft 1, elevates one minority group over another minority group. The faith-based community is a minority group that is being discriminated against in Senate Bill 1 for the reasons I just discussed. In addition, Mr. Chairman, as you well know, this bill continues to give preferential treatment to same-sex couples in divorce, which is not equal. I want to thank the chairman for removing that Section 572 regarding parentage presumptions. But again, this bill is not equal, and yet it's entitled Relating to Equal Rights. Benefits for those who identify GLBT is not a zero-sum game. What is presented is the easiest solution, but is not necessarily the best solution. Finally, Mr. Chairman, freedom of religion cannot be protected without restrictions on the public accommodations law. Passing this bill without religious exemptions to our public accommodations law does, in fact, violate the First Amendment. Applying exemptions only to religious organizations prevents businesses, especially our small businesses, and individuals from expressing their religious and conscientious beliefs. The chilling effect from this would fundamentally change society and turn our Hawaiʻi into arguably a totalitarian state. So well, I want to thank the chairman as well as the co-chair for the amendments they have put in. For these reasons, Mr. Chairman, respectfully, I will be voting no.